Good evening, and thank you for joining the South Florida Pride Wind Ensemble as we celebrate 10 years of the Youth Pride Band of South Florida. I'm Dan Bassett, the Artistic Director of the Pride Wind Ensemble. The Youth Pride Band was born out of a desire for the Wind Ensemble to give back to our community. It was a time when the media spotlight was on bullying and LGBT youth especially being targeted in our schools. The Trevor Project and It Gets Better campaigns were at the forefront of the fight to keep our students safe, and we wanted to do our part. Fast forward 10 years, $144,000 in college scholarships have been awarded, and over 500 high school students have participated in this one-of-a-kind program. This isn't exactly how I'd hoped we'd be celebrating 10 years, but I'm very excited to share what we've created for you. Tonight, you will hear from the Youth Pride Band students and our guest conductors as we listen to selections from our first 9 years. I hope that you enjoy tonight's concert, and I urge you to donate to this amazing cause if you feel so moved to do so. Before we hear our first selection, I'd like to take you back to when the Youth Pride Band of South Florida was just beginning, back in February of 2012.
So Corey, where do you go to school?
The rehearsal room at St. Mark's Episcopal School in Oakland Park is new to most of the teenagers here. But they all get right to work, setting up their chairs and tuning up their instruments.
I play flute.
Christina is 18 years old and bisexual. She's president of the Gay Straight Alliance at her high school. That keeps her pretty busy. It also makes her a target.
I have been bullied almost my whole entire life.
Almost everyone in the Youth Pride Band of South Florida says they've experienced homophobia at school. Here's the boy who plays saxophone.
It really gets to you inside, and sometimes you start believing what people are saying, and it just really gets to you.
And the girl who plays clarinet.
Most of them are, oh, he's gay, or that's gay, and I hate it when people do that. It's rude, and it's a very derogatory term, and it shouldn't be thrown around like that.
They say they're sick of all the name-calling. And in the mere act of sitting together and playing music, these teens are taking a stand against it. The Youth Pride Band has 24 gay, lesbian, bisexual, and heterosexual teens who are committed to fighting anti-gay bullying. I'm Christine DiMattei in Oakland Park.
Thank you. My name is Jake Glass, and I'm in the 11th grade Northborough Prep School, and I play clarinet. I love playing with this band. It's a great sense of community. There are a lot of good friends here that I didn't have before. I also love playing the band because I feel it's very important to support the gay, lesbian, and transgender community. It has been a real honor playing with this terrific band, and thanks for your support from all of us.
Thank you, and good evening. First of all, it's a pleasure to be here. Isn't this fun? I've been a music educator for 35 years, and I have been deeply blessed to be part of the lives of many thousands of young people.
Thank you.
In season 3 of the Youth Pride Band, we were honored to have Mr. Robert Sheldon as our guest conductor and clinician. Here are two selections: Gallop from the ballet Dance of the Hours, often recognized from Walt Disney's Fantasia, and an original piece by Mr. Sheldon called Choreography.
Good evening. My name is Adam DeRosa, and I'm the president of the South Florida Pride Wind Ensemble. On behalf of our band members, I'd like to thank you so much for joining us tonight for this special concert celebration, looking back at the first 10 years of the Youth Pride Band of South Florida. If you haven't done so already, please take a moment and donate what you can, hopefully to fund future scholarships for this program that we hope will continue for many, many more years to come. Now, back to the rest of the show. Thank you.
Fourth year of the Youth Pride Band, we had grown from 24 students to over 80 participants. We also tackled some of the most difficult music the students and adults had ever played. One of the unique aspects of the Youth Pride Band is that members of the Pride Wind Ensemble coach and play alongside the students. Typically, the first half of the Youth Band concert focuses on students, while the second half features the entire mass band of the Youth Pride Band and Pride Wind Ensemble. This next piece by Frank DeKelly, entitled Blue Shades, demonstrates the incredible dedication of the adults and students involved in the Youth Pride Band program. Enjoy. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Deb Pugh.
And I'm Don Proxton.
The first year of the Pride Wind Ensemble Scholarship Program, a couple of friends of ours did donate, and they encouraged us to follow suit. The excitement and the pride that the students who won scholarships was really quite something to be a part of.
Funding for the arts in the school systems seems to be just dropping dramatically over the years. And anything we can do to help students achieve or get more musical training is something I'd like to continue.
Any of you out there who are interested to donate, and I think you'll, like us, get a lot of personal joy out of doing it.
Thank you. a band concert without an opportunity for the director to talk. I come from San Francisco, so I see gay bands all the time. I am a teacher, so I see students and young people all the time. But the synergy that this gay band has with these students is unique. It's genuine, and it is a treasure of the things that matter in this life and the things that are good. To you in the audience, and especially to you proud parents, let me join the chorus that says, your children are amazing. And to every single person here on this stage and backstage too, I say that playing with you has made me want to be a better musician, but spending time with you makes me want to be a better person. Thank you.
My name is Kayla Cuffey, and I am a junior at MacArthur High School located in Hollywood. This is my first year as a member of the Youth Pride Band. I joined this Pride Band because in middle school I was bullied, not for my sexuality, but for other reasons. I felt that I didn't have a group of friends or any friends at all that I could really talk to about my issues, let alone my family, because they weren't an option at the time. Growing up was pretty hard. I felt isolated. I felt like no one could really understand me and my emotions. People would either say I was overreacting or it was merely a phase that I was going through. But by joining this band, I found out that my feelings and my emotions are valid, that I'm not going through a phase and that I do matter. I've come to love this group of people who not only share my love of music, but also share my interest in the issues not only in the LGBT community, but in our everyday lives. This band has really taught me how to stand out, get over my social anxiety, help with my depression, and also just learn to love myself and just continue to do the best that I possibly can.
In our seventh season of the Youth Pride Band, we invited longtime friend of the band and local band director, a very accomplished composer, Mr. Robert Longfield, to conduct. He was gracious enough to share the podium with myself and our assistant conductors, Mrs. Sarah Cowley, who you'll see now leading the youth band in Raging Machines by Brian Balmages. Thank you. One of the unique side effects of creating the Youth Pride Band was the desire for our high school participants to join the Pride Wind Ensemble once they've graduated high school. Let's hear now from one of our youth band participants from season one, who is a scholarship winner, joined the Wind Ensemble after high school, and took advantage of our partnership with French Woods Festival of the Performing Arts Summer Camp as a student, and since has joined their summer staff.
Hi, my name is Julia Bravo. I play the trumpet and I'm in ninth grade at MacArthur High School. I decided to join the Youth Pride Band because I thought that it would be a great opportunity to play with people that were more experienced than me, and I thought I could learn from them, and I did.
Hi, I'm Julia Bravo, and I'm an alumni of the Youth Pride Band of South Florida. I joined the Youth Pride Band in 2011, and it was a great way for me and my friends to make music together, but also to support a cause that we cared about, which was anti-bullying. Another really cool thing that the Pride Band does is they raise money for a number of $1,000 scholarships every year, and I was lucky enough to have been a recipient of one of those scholarships. Something that the scholarship gave me that will last longer than the pure financials of it is the knowledge that somebody gave me that scholarship because they believed in me and because they wanted me to succeed. Another opportunity that I got to experience because of the Youth Pride Band is French Woods Festival of the Performing Arts. And as Youth Pride Band students, we were able to attend on partial scholarship. After attending as a camper, I took a summer off and I have been working as a staff member there since 2016. You know, overall, the Youth Pride Band and French Woods and the Pride Wind Ensemble have helped me learn what it means to be a good musician, teacher, and person. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I may, I have a few words to say about the next piece we're about to play. This piece was commissioned by the South Florida Pride Wind Ensemble in honor of its 25th anniversary, and it was premiered on June 12, 2011, right here in this room. I'm so happy that we get to play it again tonight, especially with the addition of the students. The title of this piece comes from the Robert Frost poem, The Road Not Taken. And although the poem is filled with references to roads, it really doesn't have anything to do with roads at all. The poem is about those times in our life when we have tough choices and hard decisions to make. And we can either go with the flow, take the path of least resistance, go the conventional way and the safe way, or we can take the road less traveled, even though the destination may be unclear and the journey may be risky and dangerous. So this piece is about the road less taken. Thank you.
Thank you. You know, I one of the things I love about this organization is that one of the primary functions it has is to be an advocate for people who need one, and to be an advocate for people who have been bullied and who have had a difficult time in society, which can be very difficult. You know, sometimes as a band director, music teacher, we tend to look for the kids that are the, you know, the very, very best kids and all, but there are some kids that need the band more than the band needs them, and they are just as important. I just wanted to mention that because this music has been such an important part of my life for many reasons. I've learned now that the main reason it's important is because of the people that are in it. And to be able to share music with everyone and to share with this wonderful group that's behind me here and to be able to play with them, and it's just been, for me, this is a very special weekend. And I am so honored to be able to be a small part of the year of this particular organization that is an advocate for those people who really need them. So thank you to the project.
Thank you. My name is Angel Bromer. I'm a senior at the Sagemont School, and I play the tuba. Over the time that I have participated in this group, I was able to learn from others and build my self-confidence. I have been able to push myself musically and see how I fit in with others. I have learned that no matter if you are part of the LGBT community or an ally, we can all be one big family and create beautiful music together. That with the confidence that I've gained through this experience, that I came out as transgender and pansexual. And I'm also proud to be a part of the band.
This next piece is called City Trees. City Trees was written 8 years ago and was commissioned especially for the Lesbian and Gay Band Association to celebrate their 30th anniversary. This was a really challenging piece to write for a number of reasons, but what made it particularly difficult was that I had just moved from Arizona, where I was born and went to college, to the unsympathetic chaos that is New York City. And if you've ever been to New York City, you know it does not shy away from hazing tourists or newbies like me. So when I first moved there, I felt like I didn't fit in, like I didn't belong, and it felt almost impossible to find a place to live, to not get lost on the subway, and to make new friends. And in fact, Brian here was one of my first and only New York friends for several months. So while my life seemed to be starting over in complete disarray, I had a deadline looming for this piece, and I just wasn't finding the music for it. And one of the musicians in the band was asking me, what do you do when you get writer's block? And whenever I get writer's block like this, I try to take walks to clear my head. And one afternoon, I began to notice the trees that line the city blocks. Not the fancy, much-celebrated trees in Central Park or anything like that, but the trees in my neighborhood. And I started to notice how out of place they actually appeared. Like, when you look at these trees, they're all kind of shackled to the earth by the sidewalk around them and the asphalt. I mean, like, a lot of these trees only have sort of enough earth to grow in that's maybe the size of this podium, maybe. It's such a small amount of space. A lot of them have fences around them, and most of them have, of course, like, cigarette butts and other, like, various garbage nestled underneath them. But as I continued my walk, I passed by bigger trees that had been in the neighborhood for what must have been decades. Trees that have grown so tall and become so strong that their roots have actually broken through that concrete around them. And I found that image so striking and so comforting. And I think I realized in that moment that it takes time, who knows, maybe years, to adapt to new places. And the longer that I live there now, the stronger my own roots become, and the more I feel like maybe I do belong there. Enjoy, City Trees.
Thank you.
even though we did not have a formal program this year, we invited all of our 11th graders from last year's Youth Pride Band to apply for a $1,000 college scholarship. I'm proud to announce that we're awarding 4 scholarships this evening.
Hello, my name is Sebastian Cristancio, and I'm a senior at Cypress Bay High School. The most memorable part was performing on stage at Parker Playhouse, surrounded by top talent. I've applied to Florida Atlantic University, where I plan to major in commercial music and minor in computer science.
Hi, my name is Isabella Borges. I attend College Academy at Broward College, and I play the flute. My favorite part about Youth Pride is that everyone's ready to learn and collaborate and willing to further their musical experience and knowledge, regardless of who they are or what difficulties might stand in their way. I hope to be able to complete my education in biology and hopefully get a bachelor's and master's and other such programs, and eventually apply to medical school while keeping myself in music and close to the people I love. And yeah, thank you for your time.
Hello, my name is Jaden Bravo. I'm a trombone player from MacArthur High School, and I've been in Pride Band for 3, going on to 4 years, and it's been such a great experience. I first joined to play with my brothers and sisters, and to meet a bunch of new people that share the same passion as I do. One of my favorite parts is seeing everybody share the same passion and come together, no matter how different we are, no matter the differences we have, to come together and make some beautiful music. I plan to go to college for business, and I've been looking at colleges like UCF, FSU, FAU.
Hi, my name is Haley Herrera, and I am currently a senior at MacArthur High School. My favorite part about being in the Youth Pride Band is when we get to meet the composer of the music that we are playing that year, and when we learn the true meaning and emotion that's supposed to be conveyed when the composer wrote the piece. For college, I am applying for FAU and FIU, and I'm considering 2D animation or music performance. For my final remarks, I would like to say that I appreciate the Youth Pride Band and their efforts in providing for us as much as they possibly could for this group, even in these tough times. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. I hope that you've enjoyed tonight's concert. I'd like to thank our board of directors and all of our sponsors. If you'd like to contribute to a partial or a full $1,000 college scholarship to be awarded next year, or would like to contribute to the sustainability of our organization, please use the donation link on your screen or visit our website, www.pridewindensemble.org. And now our final selection will be conducted by Mr. Brian Warsdale, who's the Artistic Director at Frenchwoods Festival for the Performing Arts, as well as our guest conductor from Season 9. Our guest composer was Mr. Michael Markowski. Thank you, and have a wonderful evening, and thank you for tuning in.
We're going to close this first half of the concert with a piece called Reckoning, which I like to think of as sort of an underdog story, or like a David versus Goliath type of story. The piece opens in a world just full of despair and devastation, and from that dark place, the band kind of rallies together in an effort to maybe confront or overthrow their oppressor. But I think the question is, will they succeed?
I hope that you've enjoyed tonight's performance. Our next show, Keep It Light, Keep It Bright, Keep It Gay, will be another virtual concert broadcast on Sunday, May 16th at 7 p.m. and will feature small ensembles from the Pride Wind Ensemble. You can keep up to date with the band through our website, www.pridewindensemble.org, or on our Facebook page. Thank you so much for joining us, and have a great night.